Meanwhile, the probability that the rivalry between great powers in world politics is cyclical is high. Hegemons periodically come and go in world politics. How? From 1495 to 1540, Portugal was the dominant state in world affairs, competing with France, England, and Spain. The War of Italy and the Indian Ocean from 1494 to 1517 led to the Treaty of Tordesillas of 1517. After this period, Spain rose to outshine Portugal in European affairs, which can be likened to world affairs, as Europe was the center of great power rivalry. With the truce of 1608, the church became a dominant player in the politics of Europe. The Roman Empire led this stage, following the 30 Years' War from 1618 to 1648. And that 30 Years' War caused the defeat of the Habsburg dynasty in Spain and Austria-Hungary. After the 30 Year War, a new order was born with the Peace of Westphalia. Napoleon Bonaparte's France dominated Europe from 1792 to 1815 until he was defeated in the Battle of Waterloo in 1815. The Concert of Europe is the peace deal that launched what has been described as the first international organization to check the excesses of countries threatening global peace. From France to Britain, Germany, Japan, and even Italy, and later the United States and the Soviet Union, there is the subject of balance of power in world affairs. Another phase is unfolding. You would note that this periodic change in the balance of power politics was accompanied by wars in the past. The Second World War threw up America as a superpower. What kind of war would throw up the next hegemons? I'm looking at technological war. Technological war. The reason I have come with technological books for you. Have you read this book? Blockchain Revolution. How the technology behind Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies is changing the world. You know, we are talking about Nigerian government versus Binance or Binance. That is a game. Binance is about cryptocurrency. The Tinubu government says Binance could speculate about the naira and the dollar and indirectly control the economy. It is the power of tech. Would the Tinubu government be able to defeat Binance? Do we have the technological know-how to counter Binance and other intruding technologies? By the way, have you studied blockchain? Read this book, Blockchain Revolution. Classical work written by father and son. It is one of the best books on technology in the 21st century. Blockchain Revolution. How the technology behind Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies is changing the world. Blockchain technology will change the world. In fact, it already has. Blockchain is the technology driving the future of the economy. It's best known for powering Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies. But it has the potential to transform every industry it touches. It allows virtually anything with value, from stocks, music, and intellectual property, to health records, and even identities, to be stored in a secure and anonymous system that no one person or company owns. From birth and death certificates to insurance claims, land titles, and even votes, data will never be managed in the same way again. Written by Don Tapscott, the author of Wikinomics, and his son, blockchain expert Alex Tapscott, Blockchain Revolution is not only an essential and simple introduction to a complex subject, it is also a vital guide to how it will change all our lives. Read it or be left behind. Read it or be left behind. Blockchain Revolution, a classical read. Get your copy on udarabooks.com. Udarabooks.com. Or you contact us on WhatsApp. Our WhatsApp numbers are on the screen. We have copies for you. I have introduced 4 books to you. Coders, Cliff Thompson. Who are they? What they think? And how they are changing our world. Yellow books. Yellow like me. All right. I've introduced that to you. I have introduced the digital Silk Road to you. China's Quest to Wire the World and Win the Future by Jonathan Hillman. We have run out of copies. We don't have this anymore. But find it. I recommend it to you. Get a copy of this book. If you don't read it, you'll be left out. This is the one I'm presently reading. The Coming Wave by Mustafa Suleiman. Technology, Power, and the 21st Century's Greatest Dilemma. Great read. We are approaching a critical threshold in the history of mankind. So The Coming Wave is a great read. Technology, Power, and the 21st Century's Greatest Dilemma. Those are the books I have recommended to you. I am not done. More books are coming your way. Read about tech. Understand the new world. It's a world of knowledge. Is Africa playing in that world?